็เราเลือกอาชีพนักมวยครับก็ขึ้นไปบนเวทีก็อย่าไปกลัวครับก็ลูกได้นับครับแล้วก็ข้ออาการเวลาเราต่อยท้องอะไรเงี้ยครับเราเดินติดตัวเลยเขาออกอาการเยอะครับแล้วเขาก็โดนนับโชคกับพี่สามเอก่อนเขาจะเป็นแชมป์ครับก็เคยดูในการเขาชกก็เขาว่าเป็นฝรั่งนักชกที่อันตรายครับน่ากลัวเหมือนกันก็เราก็ประมาทไม่ได้เลยครับกว่าเราจะเป็นรถถังครับก็แม่เอกับพ่ออ้วนซึ่งพ่ออ้วนเสียไปแล้วใช่ครับแล้วก็เหลือแม่เอครับเขาดูแลมันตลอดเหมือนเขาให้ชีวิตเราอะให้ชีวิตเราใหม่ในทางที่ดีขึ้นว่าดูแลมันตลอดตั้งแต่เล็กจนเป็นแชมป์ที่หนึ่งมากครับก็ทุกครั้งตอนที่พ่อว่ายังอยู่ก็แบบเขาจะโทรมาตลอดถ้าผมไม่เข้าซ้อมเขาจะโทรมาว่าให้เข้านะลูกอย่างนู้นอย่างนี้ครับก็สำคัญมากครับสำคัญกับตัวเองด้วยความฝันของนักมวยทุกคนที่เลือกอาชีพนี้หนึ่งอยากจะเป็นแชมป์ไม่ได้ใช่ครับแล้วก็เราประสบความสำเร็จแล้วก็เป็นตัวอย่างให้กับน้องๆที่ค่ายต้องเป็นคนใหม่ครับแบบต้องแบบในสไตล์รถถังที่แบบสมชื่อครับให้แฟนมวยที่มาชมทั่วโลกก็ได้รู้แบบอาวุธของมวยไทยในรูปแบบที่ผมเป็นครับก็ตอนนี้ก็ต้องการแชมป์ของตัวเองแล้วก็ยิมแล้วก็ตัวแทนนักชกไทยแชมป์มวยไทยก็ต้องอยู่คู่กับนักมวยไทยครับ
It could be Brawn versus Brains. The Brawn of Rodtang, the Brains of Sergio Wilson. Wilson has beaten Thais, most notably his 32nd head kick knockout of the great Anawat in 2010 in Geneva. Could he pull off the upset against Rodtang tonight? It's a one super series Muay Thai clash.Outside leg kick and head kick early on from Sergio Wilson. He will waste no time. He's going to try and catch Rodtang cold here. And there's Rodtang. A left hook and a straight right hand, followed by a front kick to the midsection.
You can definitely see that Sergio Wilson knows the atmosphere of the ONE Championship, but he also understands the rule set. So he's coming on a lot faster than normal.
Rodtang, renowned in Thailand for not taking a backward step, always coming forward. A dropping knee from Wilson.A counter left hand there from the tank, Rodtang.
Wilson landed a nice little uppercut then, but he got caught flying in with an uppercut. Beautifully done by Rodtang.
Let's see if Rodtang gets on the inside. Starts going to the liver, starts going to the solar plexus, starts going to the spleen of Wilson. Wilson goes to the inside leg. Front kick again from Rodtang. This one opening at a cracking pace. A Muay Thai match in the ONE Super Series. Outside leg kick from Wilson.Suriname has produced so many great kickboxers over the years, the likes of Tyrone Spong, Remy Bunjaski, Melvin Manoff, Ernesto Hoost, and here we have Sergio Wilson.
That battle between the Netherlands and Thailand continues here at ONE Super Series.
Looking for a dump there, maybe. Rodtang threads the left hand nicely. Rodtang outside thigh kick, then a front kick to the midsection, uppercut.Went higher than my cholesterol. Left hook, right hand there from Rodtang. A high right roundhouse. And just gets upended. 1 minute 25 remains. No feeling out process here in the opening round. They clinch up now. A chance for the knees. A chance for the elbow. And referee Onari breaks them.
I like how Rodtang utilizes that uppercut. It's a beautiful cutting uppercut, especially because Wilson's got a little bit of a height advantage on it. Beautifully throws that kick to the side, attacks the body.
Oh, what a dump! What a dump there from Rodtang. My word! The way he pivoted and wrenched
Wilson to the canvas, and there's the tough fucking right hand. Here's the power from Rodtang. There's the left hand.
Oh, he's wobbling.
Wilson's a rubber leg. He goes down. That's the night on the ring. Rodtang. Take comes forward again. There's the left hand. The tie tank. There's the left again. And Wilson's knees buckle. No knockdown there. Can Sergio survive the round? Here comes Rodtang again. Amazing scenes here in Jakarta. Rodtang absolutely unloading on Wilson. We thought he'd knocked him out.
Chiavello thought it was over. Rodtang thought it was over. The only one who didn't think it was over was Sergio Wilson. Look at that, catching the punch on the head. He goes to Wobble Street, falls down. Beautiful left hook. Look at this. No legs. Legs won't stay under him. Equilibrium is gone. And that's when he called. He heard the goodnight Irene as he scaled the cage.
You have seen why Rodtang is considered the hottest Muay Thai athlete on the planet. Devastating with these 4-ounce bucks. My word. He put some punishment on Wilson. But let me tell you, before that, Wilson got in some blows of his own, and Sergio's not done yet.
What if there's a little bit of an adrenaline dump? If you think you win, that's a surge of adrenaline that's gonna be, you know, rushing through your body. And then to get called back into action, have to get down off the cage, that's gonna change your entire body chemistry, Michael.
Second round, one Super Series Muay Thai matchup. The incredible Rodtang, the amazing Sergio Wilson. Only one can prevail. They touch gloves and we're underway. And Wilson comes out aggressively. Two-punch combination and a front kick. There's another front kick from the Dutchman. And here comes Rodtang. They want to go toe-to-toe now. Rodtang comes forward, thrusts out the jab. There's a right hand. Cutting side kicks from Rodtang. Chasing Wilson across the cage. Wilson throws a hook and a straight punch.
Wilson's still a bit wobbly. He doesn't have his legs completely under him. Beautiful push kick. Caught him coming in.
Through an elbow there, Rodtang. There's the left hook. Wilson's going to get off the cage. And Rodtang tries the elbow again.
Oh, man, these punches coming from Rodtang, they sound like a bag full of hammers. They are getting thrown with some serious speed.
But Sergio's still here. He's not going to go quietly into the night. He's not going to wave the white flag. And there's another excellent execution. A beautifully timed teep to the midsection from Rodtang.
You can see it. What's cut him off balance is that Sergio is in mid-attack. As he's getting these push kicks down, it's thrown off his balance completely.
Rodtang with more kick than a chorus line. Here in the second round, there's a front kick from Wilson. Throws one off the left leg. And Rodtang comes forward again, turning back kick, looking for the liver, looking to impact that vagus nerve, and throws down the body of the tie.
But how tough is Sergio Wilson to stand there toe-to-toe with Rodtang?
Wilson went for the uppercut elbow, good evasion, he leaned back like Fat Joe. A front kick to the midsection, a front side kick to the midsection from Rodtang. This one is crazy. This one is awesome. It's one Super Series Muay Thai.
Now look at Rodtang stalking down Wilson.
Stalking? He's trying to roll through him like a tank, always coming forward. There's no backing up on Rodtang.
Look at nowhere. Just consistently moving forward. That's what's different about the cage, Michael. There's no corner to back your opponent into. It's a circle. You can continually run around, and that's what's giving Sergio Wilson a little bit of time in this one.
Amazing scene here in Jakarta for this Muay Thai match. Rodtang with the kicks again off the lead leg. Sergio spinning back fist and just upends himself. 40 seconds remaining, second round of three.
I swear, Rodtang just winked at you, Michael.
They clinch up dead center of the cage. Rodtang breaks off and chops the elbows. He comes forward now. Sergio uppercut elbow. And Rodtang chases him. There's an elbow from the Thai. There's an elbow from the Surinamese. And Rodtang just dumps him to the canvas. 15 seconds on the clock. This has been an absolute rip snorter. Wow. Take again with the power laden left hand. There's the hook. Smack bang. How is Wilson standing? A spinning back elbow and a counter elbow from Wilson. A right hand to the kisser. Rodtang with a roundhouse kick. Looks for the clinch. And there's the end of the round. This is something sensational.
Wow. Wilson is taking a beating, but he is still in there. We are seeing just what all the hype is about with Rodtang. Look at that beautifully timed push kick right as Sergio Wilson is about to even attempt to think about attacking him. He gets pushed back onto his butt. There's a nice little elbow though landed by Sergio Wilson. But look at this control from Rodtang. All the hype, it's real, folks. Rodtang is the real deal.
The hottest Muay Thai athlete on the planet. Started training as an 8-year-old. Had his first match at a temple fair in a small southern Thailand village. Rodtang. And there's Sergio Wilson. Somehow the South American still here. Made his pro debut at 16. Has beaten some great Thai names. Can he beat Rodtang in front of a sellout audience inside the Jakarta Convention Center?
At this point, he's gonna have to knock out Rodtang. He's gotta be behind on every single judge's scorecard.
Third and final round, one Super Series Muay Thai match. A high right roundhouse kick there from Sergio Wilson. Backs him up with the left hand out of southpaw stance. There's a wild hooking right from Wilson. He's opened up like a house on fire. Overhand elbow from Rodtang.
He's marching forward. There's no fear in his eyes. He's continually pushing forward, challenging Rodtang to throw down with him.
Have you ever seen a walk forward style like Rodtang is showing us tonight? He doesn't take a backward step. He doesn't know how to go in reverse.
Man, you can just see the swagger just oozing out of Rodtang. Just the confidence and belief in himself.
Straight right hand and a short right elbow. Smack bang on the kisser. Gives the beard a shave of Sergio Wilson. Wilson now with the knees, and Rodtang just ragdolls him and dumps him to the canvas.
Look at him just staring him down, begging him to get up so he can take more of this beating.
Sergio sticks out a stiff jab. That was nicely done. Rodtang goes for the headache maker. There's the uppercut elbow. A wild hook again from Rodtang. He's had more hooks than a Pirates convention. He comes forward again. Overhand right there from Sergio Wilson. Rides the head kick, covers up with a forearm. Rodtang catching right hand, but only a slip, says referee Onari. No count on Wilson. Picks himself back up. 1 minute 30 remains.
Wilson's continually trying to push forward, but look at this push kick. The timing is beautiful on it. Every single time Wilson enters that range, boom, the push kick's right there.
Again. Beautifully done from Rodtang. Keeps Wilson at bay. What has Sergio Wilson got left in his bag of tricks? This cerebral Muay Thai athlete from the Netherlands. And Rodtang comes forward. Sergio thrust out the left hand. They tango back against the cage. No knees thrown, and referee, oh no, he breaks them. Under a minute remaining now. Right hand from Rodtang. They clinch up another dump from the tie. That is Muay Thai 101. And once again, Wilson's got to pick himself up off the floor.
Go!
Let's see if Rodtang goes back to the liver. Dips the right hand to the bread basket. Forces Wilson back against the cage. And Wilson comes forward. What guts, what tenacity here from the multi-world champion, Sergio Wilson. How many shots to the body has he taken from those kicks? There's one to the liver. There's one to the solar plexus. Sergio Wilson looks spent here. The final 15 seconds. The side of the head. It's a second knockdown from Rodtang.
Six, seven.
That left hand has been superb.
You said what makes Rodtang so tough, what makes him so hard to deal with, you said it was his body shots. And that is what is breaking Sergio Wilson. Look at these push kicks continually going after the body over and over again. And Sergio Wilson just looks dejected.
Rodtang is a Muay Thai monster. The hype. At one Super Series, and look at the respect. Look at the integrity, the martial arts code. But there's no doubt about this one. That young man, now signed to one Super Series, shows why. He is quite simply the hottest Muay Thai talent in the world right now.
Man, the whole show was about Rodtang. Look at this. Beautifully done. He faked the push kick, but still landed it on the second attempt. That was picture perfect. And he was sliding in with attacks over and over again. The push kicks were beautifully done in the third round. But what they were doing is they were setting up so many other attacks. He was utilizing beautiful push kicks to punch combinations. And then he goes after the body. Look at that. Body, head, head, kick to the body. Beautifully done. The hype train is real behind Rodtang.
You're gonna take your hat off to Sergio Wilson if you're wearing a hat. An amazing performance from the Surinamese Dutchman, but tonight belongs to Rodtang.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. From the blue corner, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
He is quite simply on another level, Rodtang. The respect there, tremendous. The martial arts spirit shining through. We're going to see more of Sergio Wilson. We're going to see more of Rodtang Jitmuangnon. One Super Series debut for this megastar. And he takes the winner's medal back to Thailand.
Regarded as the best Muay Thai warrior on the planet right now, Pan Payak makes his one Super Series debut against Rui Botello. They are wearing 4-ounce gloves. The cage doors are locked. Referee Atsushi Onari gets us underway. Pan Payak in the glittering gold in southpaw starts. He opens up the front kick and then a high-left roundhouse kick. Watch for the excellence of execution in everything that Pan Payak does. Step through knee. Left cross from the tie. Botello's got to find a way to get on the inside. Get within range, get through the reach and go to the jaw. Go to the liver, go to the ribs of Pan Payak. He's got to guard up against that left roundhouse kick.
He's got to keep that guard high, but he's also got to start circling. He's got to start circling to his left to avoid that big left roundhouse kick.
Pan Payak is patient. Cracks away to the inside lead by the Portuguese. Botello tests the waters downstairs. Needs the right hand for company. Double forearms guard against that left roundhouse kick. Botello far too flat-footed at the moment. He's got to move. He's got to start drifting to his left.
Standing right in front of Pan Payak. He's got to start moving. Put those hands in. Closing that distance. He's right in the perfect zone. That left kick.
That no man's land. In range for everything Pan Payak wants to throw it in. He throws a left hand down the center corridor. Payak patience, very light on the lead leg, tracks away with that back leg again. That fabled, that feared left roundhouse kick with Pan Payak Jitmuangnon. Front kick for the midsection, digs into the belly button. There's one to the top of the leg. Roundhouse kick again from Pan Payak. Nice right hand lever from Botello. That's more like it from the Portuguese athlete. Roundhouse kick slapped into the lower ribs there off the left from Pan Payak. First time in these 4-ounce gloves.
Now the 4-ounce gloves change a lot of things. You know, they change the defense. They change, you know, how you're going to counter, how you're going to move in. You know, you got to be very careful. But it also makes the clinch very effective, and it also adds a whole new element of power to the game.
Botello said he studied a lot of tape from Pan Payak, and he said that in what he'd studied and having seen Pan Payak get knocked out before, that Pan Payak does a little lift often before he kicks. And if he can time Pan Payak on that lift, Botello may be able to connect, maybe with a roundhouse kick of his own. But being quite the shorter here, it will take a phenomenal effort to loop the roundhouse kick around the back of Pan Payak's neck.
Now that you mention it, you can start to see it. It's like a slight skip with his lead foot when he sets up that big roundhouse kick. It's a slight little step to initiate a little bit more power into the left kick, but it comes very fast. Your reaction time needs to be incredibly quick. Here's Pompeo coming straight through the middle with a beautiful left hand. And there's that left kick again. But Rui Botello was able to catch it on the arm there. He's taking a lot of shots. That's about 6 shots he's been able to catch on the arm. He's got to make sure he keeps that arm looped nice and tight to his head. Ladies and gentlemen, you guys can vote for Bout of the Night on the One Super App. And you can win a trip to join us at a One event, which is probably the greatest event in the world of sports, Michael Schmello.
It is Destiny of Champions here tonight in Kuala Lumpur. It's not probably, it is Mitch Chilson.
There you go.
Final One Championship show of the year. Second round of this One Super Series match. Pampayet on debut, taking on Rui Botello. Thailand versus Portugal. Let's see if Rui can pick up that little lift that Pampayet does before he kicks. He believes it could be the chip in the armor. Nope. Something I've never seen before. Pompeo's trainer has his marker around his neck. Now, it's usually on a ring post. There are no ring posts here with the cage, however, but I hope in a very superstitious martial art that does not bring Pompeo any bad luck. Probing the leg kicks here. Rui Botello, forearms guard against the high left roundhouse. Goes for the inside thigh. Nice and high to that femoral profundo with Pompeo. Salo in the traditional Portuguese colors, the green and red.
Botello looks very effective when he's moving forward. When he starts throwing those hands, he closes the distance quick, but he's also getting caught with a little bit of a left hook by Pompeo.
Botello landed a good combination a few moments ago that should give him some more confidence. Goes forward again. A cracking roundhouse kick from Pompeo came agonizingly close. Botello fires out a front kick off the back leg. Pompeo left drop down the center. Body kick from the Thai. Roundhouse kick upstairs again. Botello sees them coming. It's one of those wicked roundhouse kicks like put down or like Yodson fly. It could do so much damage. Fake there from Pompeo. Goes upstairs again, just breaking down that right arm of Rui Botello. There's only so many kicks Botello can take to that right forearm before the arm drops, and then we'll see if Pompeo can come over the top with a big kibosh.
I'd like to see Pompeo start going to the body of Botello more. Get him to start protecting that rib, that right side of his body with the elbow, and then he can start working his way up to the head. Botello's okay to take those on the arm.
Botello unloading on Pompeo for a moment, and the crowd rallied behind the Portuguese star. Under a minute remaining, second round of three. Three judges are scoring on a 10-point must system. You give the winning boxer 10 points, the less dominant boxer 9 points.
Oh, there's the big roundhouse kick! Botello's on rubber legs, he goes down!
5, 6, 7, 8.
Botello's up at the count at 7. Pompeo gonna finish the Portuguese warrior. This place goes bananas.
Botello's got to start moving. He doesn't want to stand there. He doesn't want to stand in front of
Pompeo. Here comes Pompeo. Is he gonna finish? A left hand smack back between the eyes.
How patient Pompeo is, weighing, measuring. He might let Botello off the hook here and let him out of this round.
Botello still hasn't the cobwebs, and that's a 10-8 round for Pompeo.
Watch this beautiful left high kick. He faints with the push kick. He was landing the push kick all night. Lifts that push kick up and then comes right over the top. Look at the delayed reaction. Botello crumbles to the ground. Let's see that from a different angle. Beautifully done. Botello thought he was going to the body, kept the elbow tight, and he got caught right on the right side of his head. Beautifully timed right high kick.
Don't forget to check out our official One merchandise. Go online, shop.onefc.com. I told you that Pampayak was the excellence of execution in Muay Thai, and you saw one of the finest roundhouse kick knockdowns you're ever going to see from that man, Pampayak. Third and final. Unofficially, first round Pampayak 10-9, second round Pampayak 10-8. That is our unofficial scorecard.
Final round!
Go!
Atsushi Onari gets us underway, third round. The crowd want to see a big knockout. Pampayak came close to it with that roundhouse kick in the second stanza. What a weapon, what ferocity.
Tell him he just glued that right hand to the side of his head. He says he was going to circle left, but he's still standing right in the pocket. Intent to trade with Pampayak. It's a recipe for disaster, though.
Botello has not adhered to the game plan he said he would. Big front kick there from Pampayak. There's the high kick again. He's got more kick than a drowning horse, has Pampayak. Botello puts it on the inside. Catches the kick again. Tries for a left hook.
That's his combination. He goes for that push kick with the lead leg, with the lead right leg, and then he comes over top with that right roundhouse, left roundhouse kick. He faked it, and that's what caught Botello. He was expecting the push kick to come in, but he faked it, lifting up his left right foot and coming over the top of the left kick.
Go!
Pampayak looks fresh. Not a drop of sweat on him. Not a bruise, not a scratch. He has been dominant in his one Super Series debut. And that left roundhouse kick has been something extraordinary to behold. Inside leg kick from Botello. Roving with the jab, the Portuguese. Got to go to his left. He continues to wear these roundhouse kicks. That one was dropped to the ribcage. 1 minute 20 remains. Pampayak sends him five paces back with a front kick to the solar plexus.
Those push kicks that are setting up that left roundhouse kick, it comes from the front with the lead leg, and it's also coming from the back. It's both an offensive and defensive weapon.
Oh, he knocks him! The left hand! Referee Onari says no knockdown, but that was a beautiful left hand from Botello.
So give Botello some confidence. He needs to take advantage of that.
No knockdown, says the referee. Can Botello capitalize, though? That left hand's been his best weapon, the little man from Portugal.
And you hear the cracking sound. That left kick is landing on the right hand of Botello.
And the clinch here, no knees exchange. Referee, oh, no pressure. As Botello got another one of those left hooks in the final 25 seconds. Left hook, right hand, the old 3-2 combination there from the Portuguese. Botello's got a swing, and he's got a swing now. Final 10 seconds. It'll be a decision win for Pampayak unless Botello can find a Hail Mary left hook here.
So push
kick from Pampayak.
Look at the way he's throwing those push kicks, Michael Schiavello. He's consistently attacking with the front push kick, with the back push kick. And that's what led to the damage that was inflicted in the second round. He was landing that push kick, and then he fakes the left push kick. Watch his right, watch his left leg. Boom, it comes up, gets Botello thinking about it, and boom, he comes right over the top, and Botello crumbles to the ground. Beautiful display of Muay Thai craftsmanship from Pampayak. But Botello started to come back and surge forward, in that third round. But overall, Pampayak, brilliant performance in his debut in one Super Series.
Pampayak looking unscathed. We believe the winner's medal will go back to Thailand. Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Pampayak Jitmuangnon.
No doubt about it, Pampayak takes it. By decision here in Kuala Lumpur, the winner's medal goes back to Thailand. What a debut at one Super Series for the great Pangpayak Jitmuangnon.